Generally, I think what you're going to see is $100 trillion worth of capital flow out of investment properties in the developed world into Bitcoin. I think Bitcoin as a network is going to continue to grow, and it's going to demonetize other assets. And that the assets it's going to demonetize will be a function of the cultures that it's within. So for example, in a culture where you have hyperinflation and the government collapses, it's going to demonetize the currency because everybody desperately needs a currency and there isn't an alternative. In a culture where people feel it's unsafe to own property, like for example, if you had weak property rights and you felt like the government was going to seize your house or seize your land, or you couldn't own land, maybe it's illegal to own land, then Bitcoin's going to demonetize the property. Like if you have $1 million, you're not going to invest it in land if you don't trust your property rights. Like for example, like I wouldn't be comfortable making an investment in an apartment building in a city that has shown itself willing to strip landlords of their rights. Right. So you're holding an apartment building. You can't charge your tenants to live in the apartment building, nor can you evict them. Okay, what's the logical value of the building? Does it go up or does it go down in that circumstance? And if I have discretionary cash, am I going to reinvest it in more apartment buildings or not? And I think the answer is wherever we see property impaired, the monetary energy in the property is going to flow to an alternative, which is better. So in the US, I think that in the US, people are comfortable with the US dollar, and what they're not comfortable with or less comfortable with is maybe risky stocks or risky property investments or say gold, things like that. And so it's logical that Bitcoin strips the monetary premium from commodities, securities, indexes, credit. Like for example, I got $1 million and I could invest it in 30-year T-bills yielding 1.6%, or I could buy Bitcoin. Well, you know, what's gonna happen there is my company had a lot of that, right? We would normally put 90% of our treasury into sovereign debt, and only 50 million of it or 10% of it was sitting in cash. So what we did is we demonetized the sovereign debt for the most part, and we rolled into Bitcoin. So I think in the developed world, in Europe and the US, I think that Bitcoin's going to demonetize debt, low-grade debt or low-yielding debt and credit. It's going to demonetize savings accounts. But I mean, most people had already given up on savings accounts by the time we got the last year. What'd they go to? ETFs. And so I think Bitcoin actually grabs monetary energy or capital from ETFs, from commercial real estate, and from debt in the developed world. I think in the developing world, and you know, in places like Iran, even in China, in North Korea, in Lebanon, in Syria, in Iran, in Iraq, in Afghanistan, lots of places like that. Well, you don't have a stable banking system. You're not even dollarized. Your currency is much worse than that, right? So I think that what you're going to see is that if there's 180 countries or something out there, I think that 15 or 20 of them keep their currency privileges. I think the bottom 100 are going to lose their currencies. I think they're going to dollarize first. Everybody wants to, but how do I dollarize? The best way to dollarize is the El Salvador strategy, which is I have a mobile application which has got dollars and it's got Bitcoin on the Lightning Network. What you want is you want a currency as a medium of exchange. It's like a stable value coin, stable versus all of the pricing of the retailers. And that's like a dollar. It's probably the most stable thing in the universe. And then you want an asset, which is an appreciating token that will hold its value over time. And that's Bitcoin. And if you wanted to maximize your utility, you kind of put 90% of your balance sheet into the asset, into Bitcoin, And then you put the last piece, the working capital or the checking account, into whatever's the currency that most of the retailers that you're surrounded with take. So if I was in Japan, I'd be holding 1 month worth of yen. And if I was in Italy, I'd be holding 1 month worth of euro. And if I'm in the US or a dollar economy, I'm holding 1 month worth of dollars. And then the rest I'm sweeping into my long-term asset portfolio or property portfolio. And my stack of property is, you know, maybe I buy a property to live in because it's a nice house and I want to live in it for the rest of my life and I can't rent it, maybe. And maybe I buy my trophy art, or, you know, maybe I buy the picture because I love the picture, or maybe I buy the car, or maybe I buy the boat, or maybe I buy the plane or something because I want to fly in it, float in it, live in it, whatever I want to do. But all my discretionary asset, I would put into the highest quality property, which is, of course, Bitcoin. So generally, I think what you're going to see is $100 trillion worth of capital flow out of investment properties in the developed world into Bitcoin, and the currencies, the euro, the dollar will get stronger. Like strong, by stronger, I don't mean stronger in purchasing power. I mean, you'll probably see the dollar become a currency used in El Salvador, and you'll see it used in Venezuela, and you'll see it spread to Argentina. And why wouldn't you see it spread to every country in Africa? Like, name a currency in Africa that you would prefer to hold in your wallet versus the dollar. None, I think, right? Is there a better currency than the dollar in Africa? But you know, if I have $10,000, I'm probably going to hold $50 in my currency wallet. And I'm going to convert the other $9,950 into Bitcoin, because that's my checking account versus savings account. And even then, you know, the best thing, I think, the ideal situation you want to get to eventually is I put 100% of my assets into Bitcoin, and then I have a credit card / credit line, which is drawn against which is converted into local currency, and it is drawn against the Bitcoin. So I have $10,000 of Bitcoin, and I want to spend $37. So I spend $37, and now I owe $37 against my my 50 million Satoshis. And I never really sell my Bitcoin. I just generate a debt against the Bitcoin. And this is, we're a little bit early here, but if your expense ratio is less than your expected appreciation over time, that is to say, if you expect Bitcoin to go up 10% a year, and if you have $1 million in assets and your expenses a year are $50,000, so your expense ratio is 5% a year, and you expect Bitcoin to appreciate at 10% a year, if your expense ratio is less than your expected appreciation over time, you never have to sell anything ever. You can borrow against your assets from now to the end of eternity. Now, it requires that you have a Bitcoin banking sector developed, right? You have to have a credit line against the Bitcoin. And we see that developing in different ways around the world. But ultimately, that would be the ideal situation. You would want to have a situation where you're holding Bitcoin and you're drawing credit lines in the currencies that exist. And I think what we'll see is the world will reduce down to 10 currencies or 5, the Chinese currency, the US dollar, the euro, right? The only way currency can exist is for the government to stay viable. And, you know, there's no Afghan currency right now, right? I mean, it's not going to be one of those. So if you're spending anything, what are you going to be spending, right? It'll probably dollarize. If it isn't, it's already dollarized, right? So I think that what we see is a collapse of currencies to a few. And I think you see the collapse of properties to a few, right? Like, for example, there's 100,000 buildings in the US you can buy for the cost of one Bitcoin, or you can buy Bitcoin. Which of the two is the easier decision? So presumably it's like a lot of things that are manufactured as stores of value, a security, a REIT, a bond. It's like, why do I need all that stuff if I can just buy Bitcoin?